Hey guys, and welcome to my Stoneblock 3 world, where we're going to go through how to use refined storage for all of your hoarding needs. Also, at the end of the video, we're going to have a look at my current setup and take a peek at the data center I've built in my basement to deal with some of the limitations that refined storage has in Stoneblock 3. So, the core component of your refined storage network is your controller. You can only have one of these on a network, and the controller will show you a list of all of the other blocks you have connected to your network, along with how much power it's using. So if I place this block right here in front of my flux point, there are many ways of powering these blocks. I'm using the flux power network here, but if you're early game and you don't have much experience in modded Minecraft, I recommend that you start with the Stirling Dynamo, this thing right here. Because this converts coal into power. Doesn't have to be coal blocks, it can be normal coal, and it's producing quite a bit. And the next block that we're going to place is the disk drive. This basically is a cabinet that has a drawers in it where you can put your actual hard drive. Just like your computer at home, it needs a disk in it before you have any actual storage capacity. And to craft your first disk, you need a storage part right here and a storage housing. You just place them next to each other in your grid and then you will get a storage disk. The storage part is your actual storage chip, and the housing is just to make it fit into our disk drive here. Just like so, and as the disk is placed in, you can see that the capacity on the side here is now up to 1K, which is the size of our storage disk. Now later on, when you upgrade these and you want to reuse the housing, you can detach the storage part by crouching and right-clicking, and then you're back to just a storage housing and a separate storage part. For now, we're going to stick to the 1K storage part though. You may also notice that the disk drive here is also powered. This is because all of the refined storage blocks send power to the adjacent blocks in the same mod. It's very, very handy as you can use a single power source for all of your blocks. And now that we have a controller and a disk drive and room for 1,000 items, we want to be able to look at those items and use them for crafting. This is where we're going to need the crafting grid. The crafting grid is pretty straightforward. There are a few configurations that I recommend we have a look at though. For example, if we look at the setting at the bottom on the left here, you see that it says size, and we can set the different size that we want depending on how large of a screen we're working with or whatever preference you might have. And the setting just above that is called the search box mode. Here you can tell the interface to automatically select the search field up here when you open the interface, and you can also link it to the search field in your REI or JEI, whatever mod is in here. I think Stoneblock is currently using REI. So if we'll have a look at this, it's currently set to normal. If I switch this over to JEI synchronized and auto-selected, next time I open this up, now you can see that when I type in here, it actually types in the REI as well. This is very, very handy when you want to look at parts that you don't already own, or you are missing something for a crafting recipe, then you can already find it in REI and automatically craft it as you wish. I've now inserted some items into our storage network here, so let's have a look at autocrafting another storage part. The parts that you can see in the crafting grid here are some of the parts that you're going to need. Now the diamond is going to be used in a create mod recipe. You're going to need this to create the advanced processors. And then this is not normal iron, it's quartz enriched. And you make this using normal quartz and normal iron. Now to be able to automatically craft stuff, we are going to need the crafter. And we're going to need a pattern. You don't necessarily need the crafter manager, but it is very handy to be able to look at what's going on with your crafters and placing the recipe patterns where you want them to be. So we're going to be placing both the crafter and the manager, as well as a pattern grid. Now the pattern grid kind of looks the same as your crafting grid. However, you can't actually craft things here. So what we're going to do is we're going to search up the storage part in our JEI here. And we're going to move all of the stuff we need to create the storage part in here. And then we're going to place the pattern out on the right side and press create. Now we have a pattern that is specifically containing the recipe to create a 1K storage part. Now this storage part is going to go in the crafter manager, and you can see here that we have a single line called crafter. If you add more than one crafter to your network, all of them will show up down here and you will be able to see all of the patterns in them. So we are going to place our pattern into the crafter, and you can see that the icon is now a 1K storage part. And to be able to actually craft this, we go back into our crafting grid, and you see that now we have a storage part that has popped up here that we don't already have, but it says craft. This means that we can click it and we can select how many we want, and then it will automatically craft it for us. So if I now press start, you can see that the preview says everything is available. We have all the parts that we need. We press start and then it starts creating them automatically for us. So now that we have five more, we can grab some storage housings. Actually, we don't even have to take it out of here. Just place it in there, grab our new storage disks, and then we can place them into our disk drive. And you can see we now have 6,000 items worth of storage instead of just one. You have now successfully created your first basic refined storage network. Congratulations. There are, of course, some more blocks that we can add to our network, as well as some interesting ways to expand with more disk drives, wireless technology, and fluid storage. I'm not going to cover fluid storage today, though, but if that is something you want to see a tutorial on, let me know down in the comments, and maybe it'll happen. We are, however, going to look at some of our options. First of all, we have the crafting monitor. This is where you can monitor the crafting process from your crafters. It displays your crafting queue and shows all items that it's going to be using for the recipes. It will also tell you if something went wrong with the crafting process. So it's very handy to have around, although it's not strictly necessary. You can also cancel your crafting processes from here. And then we have the disk manipulator. This is a very useful tool to move items from one storage disk to another. So if I take a couple of the previously created 1K storage disks and make them into a 4K storage disk, we can now use the disk manipulator to move the items from the 1K storage disk to the 4K storage disk. Now these disks are in order, so to be able to get them into the 4K storage disk specifically, we just place that one first. Now, I take the 1K drive that currently holds all of the items that we have on our network, and I take it out of the disk drive, and I bring it with me to the manipulator, and I place it in the in slot. And as you can see, it now starts draining the items out of it. So if we go back over here, you can see that the items taken out of the old drive are being put into the 4K storage drive. This is something that we use quite a lot when updating drives, and you can set priorities on your disk drives. That would mean the block, not the disks themselves, but we're not going to really go into detail on that today. And then, to take your hoarding capabilities to the next level, we are going to set up some wireless technology. Now this allows you to take a wireless crafting grid, as I have over here, linked to my other network, and walk away from your network setup and still be able to access the crafting grid. To do this, we're going to use the transmitter and receiver blocks, along with a network card and a wireless transmitter. So, to set this up, you're going to take your transmitter block and you're going to connect it to your setup. And then we're going to take our receiver and we're going to go somewhere else. Now, I'm just going to plop this in a corner over here because I don't have a wireless crafting grid that is connected to this specific setup. But we can show you how it works anyway. Now, once you have your receiver, then you're going to take your wireless transmitter and place that connected to this block. It doesn't have to be on top. It can be on any side that you would like it to. Now, this also does not require power, as you will see in a second. After these are connected, we're going to take our network card. We're going to right-click this network receiver. And as you can see here, it's now linked to a very specific coordinate. And this network card goes back to the transmitter and we're going to plop it inside of here. You can see that it says it's 17 blocks away. And now it lights up over here. When this lights up, this means that we have a wireless signal that we can actually connect to. Now these transmitters, they don't have a very large range to begin with. They have 16 blocks, but we have 4 slots on the side here that we can put range upgrades in. We're not going to make any of those now, but it's important that you know that they exist. Now, as I said, I don't have a wireless grid set up to this specific network, but I do have my wireless crafting grid connected to the setup that I have in my basement. It works the same way, you just need to click on the controller. Well, actually, I think I can just do that here. And then suddenly we have a crafting grid that we can use. What happened there is I linked my wireless crafting grid directly to this setup by crouch right-clicking the controller. And once those are connected, I just need a wireless signal that we're getting from over here, and then I can access it as long as I'm in range of the wireless transmitter. It's also important to note that when you're working with refined storage, you may want to import and export items from other locations that aren't around here. And to do that, you can also use the transmitter and the receiver block, these guys right here, and you can connect the refined storage cables to them and then have importers and exporters at the end. By doing this, you can send items wirelessly back to your setup, and you can also send them from your setup to external locations to do stuff like crafting. Very neat. As promised, we're also going to have a look at my current setup and discuss an issue you might run into with storage. You can see that I have a couple of basic components connected here, as well as some messy wireless technology, and a block here that you haven't seen before. You don't really need this block, but if you're on a multiplayer server like me, you may want to protect your network a little bit. So these take security cards and you can bind them to players and set some access controls for them. Now the current issue in Stoneblock 3 is that the largest disk you can create is a 64,000 item disk. And if you're anything like me and you do a lot of automation and hoard all of the things, that might mean you need to create a lot of disks to be able to keep up with production. And to solve this, I took some cables and I ran them underground here in these ducts, as you can see, and I made myself a little bit of a data center. As you can see, I have 4 pods, and they are all filled with disk drives on each side, and they're all filled with disks. Currently, I'm only using 1K disks, but as they are expanded, we can get an absolutely boatload of storage capacity from this setup. I also have some disk manipulation stations sitting out here to handle any future upgrades and data transfer needs. And if you're wondering how many disk drives I currently have connected to the network, we can see that in the controller here, we have 120 external drives and we have the one that is connected directly to the controller. That's a lot of drives. And that, my friends, is how you get started with refined storage networks. If you have made it all the way to the end here and you enjoyed this tutorial, make sure to smash that like button and hit subscribe for more content like this. Also, any questions you may have, you can ask me down in the comments, or if you want to hang out and ask me questions live, you can find me over on twitch.tv/jackmcofficial on Thursdays, streaming from this exact world. I know we didn't cover everything, so if you want me to cover more refined storage or any other mods, make sure to let me know in the comments as well. Now, I've been Jack, and that's it for now. Bye-bye.